The federal government is being accused of using national security to distract from the COVID crisis in our nursing homes. And today there have been renewed calls for the Aged Care Services Minister to be sacked. Here's our political editor, Peter Van Onselen.
While the government used question time to throw out red herrings, firstly on China...
My government will never be the preferred partner of a foreign government.
Then on Labor's taxing ways...
And of course, he has supported death duties, Mr Speaker, and an inheritance tax.
Before this old chestnut...
What we are seeing is the alternate government is a Green and Labor alliance.
Meanwhile, Labor went after the Aged Care Services Minister, Richard Colbeck.
After all the deaths, after all the neglect, after all the horror stories, after all the staff shortages, do you finally accept that Australia's aged care system is in crisis?
I've been very careful about the language that I've used.
The aged care system is in crisis.
Last night, 10 News ran a story that headlined, Scott Morrison is getting ready to sack one of his scandal-plagued ministers. After everything we've seen in aged care, shouldn't that be you?
No, I don't believe so, Senator.
The minister actually on the chopping block is Alan Tudge.
Last night, 10 News revealed the Prime Minister plans to sack the Education Minister after Parliament rises this week. Can the Prime Minister confirm his government is falling down around him, with cabinet leaks, damaging text message leaks, and even the sacking of ministers now being leaked to undermine the Prime Minister?
I have no intention of responding in relation to inaccurate reports in the media, Mr Speaker.
Can the Prime Minister confirm the Minister for Education's name has been taken off his door?
He is not responsible, I'm sorry to inform the member, for sign writing or for placement of door names in this building.
There's only one minister whose name has been removed from their office door.
And there's only one sitting day left before a five-week parliamentary recess. For the Prime Minister, it can't come soon enough. Peter Van Onselen for 10 News First.